and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. I'm Helen from Contagious Creativity and I'm going to be creating this page today. So I'm starting off with my traveler's notebook. I've got it in this Jane Davenport butterfly book, and I'm just taking it out and finding the right page. You'll notice that I tend to write the date numbers in pencil just so that I know where I'm at. So I'm just getting my rubber to rub those out. Oh no, not yet. I'm using my clips because we're near the end of the month now, so it's a bit bulky on one side, so it tends to want to shut on me. So I put the clips on at least to begin with, just to try and keep the pages down. Otherwise, they just rise up a little bit. Then I'm rubbing out those page numbers. So you can see I'm doing two dates in one. I'm also going to be using this mandala sticker sheet from my shop and some of my own date stickers, printable, and some photographs. I've put ad in the title because most of this is all of my own stuff. So that is why that is there. So I'm going to be using lots of these mandala stickers. They are black and white, and you'll notice I had some black and white photographs as well. So I'm kind of going on a black and white with a hint of the hot pink. The reason being because I took some pictures of the girls when they were asleep, and pictures in really low light often look a bit rubbish. So I put them in black and white and it just seems to make them look a little bit better. So I had black and white pictures for those two pictures, and then I had some other pictures and I decided actually I'll do the whole thing black and white, so it doesn't look like it's not part of the whole spread, because even though it's 2 days, I like the two pages to be cohesive. So I've just trimmed off the edges. I'm pushing up the mandalas right up to the edge and cutting off some of the bits. You'll notice that I use some of the little bits that I trim off later so that things aren't wasted. Just to add lots of lovely goodness around those edges. So these mandalas are lots of different sizes, and I think they look really pretty on their own, but you'll see I do something to them a little bit later that's really, I think looks really pretty. So I've got the 2 days, and what I'm trying to do is make the top, hold on, I'm getting my lesson right muddled. The top right and the bottom left more clustery. I don't know what I'm talking about. And then the other two corners have got less. So what I mean is I'm putting more stickers up in the top, the diagonal corners, so the top right and the bottom left, and less stickers in the top left and the bottom right. Blimey, that was tricky, wasn't it? Cool. So did you hear my brain chugging along? I don't think it's whirring. It's not even at that point. It's just chugging. Don't ever be afraid to cut your stickers, particularly when they're patterned ones like this. You'll see I used a bit of this one here, and I use it again in another spot a bit later, because it looks good and you're not wasting the sticker. And also you get this lovely, like, it's just sort of squished on the page. I am talking rubbish today, but there you go, you get used to the made up words. If you come here, I make up words and I talk a load of rubbish sometimes. I'm showing you how I trim off the edges here. I didn't before because I had some other bits I hadn't quite covered up on the other side. So I just turn over the page, and it's much easier to trim a sticker if you are doing it on the back side, not back side, the back side. And then I'm using some of these little bits that I cut off just to make the bordery. Oh, see, look, I'm just making up so many words today. Making up this mandala pattern all around the edges of the page. I'm really happy with how this page comes out, actually, so I hope you enjoy it too. So I've got curved corners, so they always drive me a bit nutty, but they do look pretty, so I have to trim those corners. Then I'm using some of the little bits down the side just to make it look a bit prettier. Then I'm putting my clips back because I'm getting the book is trying to fold in on itself. Next, it's when I want to do my dates. So I tend to think about the kind of outside edges, and then I do my dates. That's normally my next port of call. You'll see I never stick things down properly to begin with because I could always move them, and as you have seen if you've watched any of my videos in the past, sometimes I get the date wrong or the day wrong, so I have to lift up stickers. So as you see, I think, oh, there's going to be a big gap there, I don't like that, and so I pop one of the half stickers that I used earlier just down there. Then I'm laying this one over the top because I quite like the way it's almost like the dates are hidden within the mandalas, and then I really mess up taking this sticker off. I don't know what I'm doing, but I end up ripping it a bit, which is a bit annoying. So I think it's because I've got another one stuck to my finger. It's not on the back of my hand this time. Then I get my dates muddled because, yeah, there you go. So it's the 24th before the 25th, strangely enough. Then I'm thinking where to put that, and again, I'm just hiding it within the mandalas. Then the next thing is to put my pictures down. They are obviously a big item, so I put those down, the biggest things first, and then I'm going to use one of these new printables. These are made with some art that I did, which is jelly prints and stencils, and then I've made them into phrases. I'm fussy cutting. How do you feel about fussy cutting? Sometimes I love it, sometimes I really can't be bothered, but today was obviously a day I could be bothered. So I'm fussy cutting sort of closely to the shape of the words, just to make that look like it's almost a sticker, I guess. And this one says proud because the pictures on the right hand side are pictures of the girls doing some homework, doing some numeracy or some maths and some spelling work, and they were really, really good and I was really proud of them. And then on the other side, I'm going to use the love this, but I'm obviously cutting it into two because it's quite large. I did cut these down I printed these off on A5 size, so if you have if you print them off on A4, you can get them even bigger, or if you print off 2 to a page or whatever, or 4 to a page, you can get them even smaller. So I love that you've got that versatility with the printables. So yes, the love this is because my youngest went to bed a bit early. She said she wanted to go to bed early because she wasn't feeling great, bless her. And my big one, she put loads of toys around her to keep her company, which was really sweet of her. So I just wanted to say I love this because I did. I loved it. It was really sweet of her. And I've also got a picture of my eldest there with her teddy bear, which used to be my teddy bear, wearing her dressing gown. And I thought that was rather cute and I loved that too. So now I've got my printables sort of positioned. I realised that picture could be a little bit smaller, so I trimmed it off. No glue, had to find another glue, so there we go, found another glue. And then I've had real problems with this glue. It sort of is concave, so I managed to like squish it all over the sides, and like, you can still, got some on the sides, which I don't notice to begin with. Try and get it down, and I still got some poking over the edge. But yeah, it's just new glue problems, but there we go. We get there. I get slightly sticky hands, so I wipe them on something. Probably my jeans, to be perfectly honest. Then I'm just sticking down all the other pictures. So these printables, they are now available in the shop, and they're all done with my own artwork. So it might be jelly prints, it might be spray, and any sort of arty kind of feel to them all. Some are stenciled, some are some are just paint. So I've used them to make these phrases, and hopefully there's phrases that aren't too specific to any one thing. So they're not spring related, they're not Christmas related, they're just ones that you can use all year round. And I really like the pink of this, and because I was doing black and white for the rest, I thought it could be really nice to have a pop of colour pinging out on the page. So again, right, laying that down, I don't know whether you can see too well, but basically the girls had a pot of pegs and a pot of numbers and a pretend washing line, i.e. I put a piece of string between some chairs, and they had to put the numbers in the right order, 1 to 20, and they did really well. They worked together as well, because Meredith is only 3, and she finds using the pegs a little bit tricky, so Bethany was helping her, which was very sweet. So now I'm thinking, what do I need to do? I find some stickers, and they are from the Happy Planner, and I'm trying to use up some of my older stash. So these literally, they don't even have a name on the sticker book that I got this sheet from. It's like probably like Planner Basics or something like that. It's incredibly old, and I hadn't used these hearts, and I was flicking through it the other day, so I pulled it out and I've put it in my little sticker box. If you haven't seen my kind of my ephemera box that I have, each month I kind of switch it out, and maybe I should do a bit more of an in-depth video in that. If you'd like it, let me know. So I've popped it in there with my other bits and bobs, so I use it because I really want to make sure I'm using my stuff. It's not just sitting on a shelf somewhere. So hearts, you know, I always love a heart. It's always makes it look good, and particularly as these were quite sweet moments, I wanted to make sure I was documenting them with some hearts as well. And then I'm thinking a bit more, and of course add some more hearts. So I'm bobbing the one there because I realise it's not going to look right if I write there, so I've filled in that little gap with a heart. Then I've done my journaling with my normal Pentel Energel needle tip 0.5. I'm adding another mandala there because it didn't really call for any writing. And I've got another little gap there, which I'm just filling in with a heart. As you can see, I've slightly moved my camera, and you can see my bits of washi that I have used to try and stop me from missing the top of the page. Then I'm trying to get this part of the mandala to fit in here because there's a gap, and I figured, oh, it's so busy, you're probably not going to be able to notice it too much if I just squeeze one in. Then the white was bugging me, so I end up taking a little bit of the next sticker next to it up, as you will see in a moment, and then laying that one just down underneath. I felt it looked better like that. No real reason other than I just thought, oh, that would look prettier if that was overlapping that way, and I feel it does. Glue down. Don't forget to glue that bit down because you've just peeled it up. So I think I'm done at this point, but then I have a little think and realise I'm not done. I'm just showing you, I've written those bits on the side just to kind of explain the pictures there. So I think I'm done, but I'm not. And then I turn off the camera and then go, it's not quite right. So I don't do this all on camera because it was quite a long time. I take some little bits of the mandalas and colour them in hot pink. It's the Tombow 725, and it works really well with the printable pink. So I thought, actually, that's going to give it a little bit more something. And I've sped this up. I don't colour in this quickly. This is double speed, so I'm really whizzing through this colouring, but I didn't do it this quickly. But it's just, you kind of get the idea. But yeah, because the stickers are printed on matte sticker paper, it's really easy to colour in. And you could make this a lovely mindfulness exercise and colour it in really beautifully, but I just wanted a hint of the pink in each of the mandalas. So you can see me frantically, really, really quick, gosh, I wish I could colour in that quickly. You can see me colouring in just little bits of the mandalas just to give a bit of the pop of pink, and I really think this finishes off the page really nicely. So that's kind of what I've done. Not kind of, that is what I've done, in fact. So here we go, this is it. So now I'm going to show it to you a little bit closer. So using the mandala stickers, some photos, some printables, and some day and date, and that is it. But I'm really pleased with it. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I hope it's been interesting to you. Please do like and subscribe if you'd like to, if you haven't already. But thank you for coming. Remember, creativity is contagious. Pass it on. See you in the next one. Bye.